Thank you for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this academics, Mohit Bhai. We'll start with the adolescent health program directly. But before that, I would like to give some definition of adolescent and young adults. Right? I like WHO has defined adolescent phase between 10 to 19 years of age. That is the second decade of the life. But again, adolescence is divided into the three groups. It is early adolescent, middle adolescent, and late adolescent phase. They have now kept one separate group like youth. It is 15 to 24 years because majority of mental and behavioral problems are same in this age group. So they have kept this in as a youth. And overall, they have included young people between 10 to 24 years of the age. So what happened? We'll see what happened during all these phases. Like in early adolescent, most of the growth is physical growth is done. Means there is a spurt of growth. There is a development of secondary sexual characteristic. In middle adolescent age, now brain started developing. So they start thinking logically. They form their separate identity from their parents. They develop new relationship with their peer, with their colleague, with their opposite sex. And there is a desire for the experimentation. This is the this time, most of the adolescent, they indulge into the all high-risk taking behavior like substance abuse and sexual abuse and everything. In late adolescent, that is between 17 to 19 years, most of the adolescent develop their distinct identity. They have their well-formed opinion and ideas. And now they have a very stable personality. They again, in middle adolescent, early and middle adolescent phase, they move out of their family and parents, but now again they come to their family, their roots, and but now with a different identity and as a mature adult, they will come back to their parents. So adolescent is a transition phase between childhood and adulthood, and it is a most complex stage of life, as we see, because they take new responsibility, they experiment with their identity, they search for their identity, and they attain their sexual maturity. And now they learn to apply their values and develop the skin. Means this is the phase where they go out of their home. Now they so choose their careers. Now they become an adult. But still, they are no longer children and yet not become adult. So we'll see the what is the status of adolescent in the India. Our country is a youngest country. Of almost 21.3% of population of our country, that is 243 million people are fall in this adolescent group. And if we include young adults, then this percentage will go up to 30%. So this second decade of life, where the major determinant of morbidity and mortality are behavior rather than congenital or infectious. If you see the child mortality or infant mortality, most of the cause are congenital or infectious causes. But here, the causes are mostly related to behavioral problems. And as adolescents make transition from childhood to adulthood, they establish behavior that decide their current and future health. Why, we will see later. So this is a very stressful time for all adolescents because they are passing through hormonal changes. They are suddenly their body start changing. They attain their sexual maturity. Their idea and concepts are changing regarding their external and internal atmosphere. They have to cope with the expectation from their children, from their parents, from their teachers and other society, because this is the time where they get all board exams. They have to select their career, they have to select their partner, right? So this is a very stressful condition for them, and after all they are establishing their own identity, so this makes a lot of pressure on them. And as WHO is depicted, like if we invest in adolescent, so we have got triple benefit, like healthy adolescent. Now if we treat them and manage them properly, so they will become healthy adolescent now, and in future they become healthy adult, and their generation, next generation will be also healthy. So this will give us a very good benefit if we treat adolescent on time. So according to UNICEF global data, like 1.3 million adolescent died in 2012. But most of them were from preventable or treatable cause. And what was the top five causes of death? Was the road traffic injuries or accident, pneumonia, suicide, diarrheal disease, and drowning. In overall, in the world, road traffic injuries is the leading cause of death all over the world. And almost 330 adolescents die every day. But in India, the suicide is the most common leading cause of death, and that too between 15 to 29 years of age group, in 15 to 29 year of age group. And other causes of death were HIV infection, suicide, lower respiratory tract infection, and interpersonal violence. If you can, in this, you can see these all are the preventable causes. They are related with their behavior and their mental health problem. So these are preventable cause. If we focus on adolescent, then we can prevent most of the death. If we can see, so burden of health problem in India is very high for adolescent. Like 4% of adolescent girls are undernourished. Sorry, it is 45%, and 20% of adolescent boys are undernourished. Early marriage, like in less than 15 years, 26% girls married before 15 years, and more than 54% girls, like half means one out of two girls married before 18 years. And all these have their bad effects in their adult role. 50% of all HIV positive new infections are in the age group of 15 to 25 years. And adolescent abortion rate is also very high. Complicated related to adolescent abortion is also very high. Here I have divided adolescent health problem in major 2-3 groups, like nutrition and nutrition related problems, behavioral and mental health problems, sexual reproductive health related problems, dermatological and musculoskeletal injury, and headache. Here we are going to discuss mostly all these nutrition, behavioral and sexual reproductive health health related problems in detail, because they are directly and indirectly affect their health in present also, and in future also, and in next generation also. So it is very important that we will discuss all these problems just now. So what are the nutrition related problems? They are undernutrition, anemia and other deficiency disorder, obesity and non-communicable diseases, and eating disorders like anorexia nervosa and bulimia. So what are the special issues of adolescent nutrition? As we see, when the child comes into the adolescent phase, like around 10-12 years, suddenly they don't like to eat at home. They don't like home food. there is a lot of peer pressure, so they always want to eat outside. Whosoever has a adolescent in the home, they have observed all these things, right? They consume, they have very less time to eat because they are very busy, and not in this lockdown period, but otherwise they have school, they have tuition, other extracurricular activity. So most of the adolescent miss one or two meal, and breakfast is the most commonly miss the meal. Again, they have very less information and knowledge regarding nutritive value of all food. They have a lot of peer pressure. Second thing, adolescent girls have to prepare for future motherhood. So all these lead to this nutritional problem. And in contrast, their nutrition requirement is increased like anything, particularly iron, calcium, calorie and protein requirement increase very much. Because during this adolescent phase, 50% of adult weight is gained in this 10 to 19 years of phase, 25% of height is gained, and 25% of muscle mass is gained during this phase. So naturally, all the nutrition requirement is increased. If we see, nearly half of the adolescent girl aged 15 to 19 years in India are undernourished, like 47% of the their total population. So this makes them they are more prone to develop all the nutrition related problems. In India, there is a lack of sun exposure with modest tradition of clothing like burqa and the wearing dupatta. So, and dark color skin pigment. See, all this lead to vitamin D deficiency. Most of the adolescent girl from the underprivileged society, they take insufficient dairy product. This will lead to protein and calcium deficiency and low bone mineral density. These affect their future health, like all knee joint problem, difficulty during pregnancy because of the contracted pelvis. All these problems happen. Even because of undernutrition, there is a delay in onset of puberty and sexual maturation, and this result in stunting, poor bone mass accumulation, and reduced work capacity in the future. So most common deficiency disorder here I discuss is anemia. According to NFHS 3, means the National Family Health Survey 3, reports that more than half of the adolescent girl and boy, they were found anemic. And the most common anemia was the iron deficiency anemia. It is a nutritional anemia. And the reason was they were not getting enough iron in their diet. There was a rapid growth spurt and increased iron requirement. In girls, they start having a menstruation. They attain their menarche, so start having blood loss, monthly blood loss. And in boy also, the increased body mass will lead to increased requirement of iron. So there is a relative iron deficiency in the boys. So anemia, what problems anemia will cause to adolescent? Young people's anemia will lead to stunted growth, decreased resistance to infection, and decreased cognitive development, and poor productivity. So what we can do to prevent anemia in adolescent? We can encourage balanced nutrition, means they should not skip any meal. At least breakfast, lunch and dinner they have to take. Weekly iron and folic acid supplementation. In India, there is a Rashtriya Kishor Yojana is there. In that, they provide free iron and folic acid to each and every adolescent. And even recommendation is also there that we should supply iron and folic acid supplementation to all adolescent girls. irrespective of their anemic status. The other cause is wasp infestation is very common in India. So biannually deworming is advisable. Nutrition counseling is must during their routine pediatric visit, because they don't have any information regarding the nutritive value of foods. So, and there is a lot of food fat during this phase. So we have to explain that what are the iron rich food and they should consume it. And if adolescent girl is having menorrhagia, then we should treat it properly so that anemia can be prevented. On the other extreme is the obesity. Obesity is an emerging public health problem among the adolescent of India. Right? Overall prevalence of obesity in India was ranging from 16.6 to 30%, up to 30% was there. And it was higher in boys than girls. 30% of obesity begins in childhood, and about 50 to 80% of obese children become obese adult. So in survey, it was found that higher prevalence among urban youth and youth of the higher socioeconomic status. And obesity in India, it was found that the children and adolescent were obese and they have multiple mineral and deficiency disorder. So they were obese, on one side they were obese, but they were anemic, they had a low calcium level, etc. So what is the definition of obesity? In adolescent, it is defined as, overweight is defined as BMI at or about 85 percentile, but lower than the 95 percentile for adolescent of same age and same sex. And obesity is defined as BMI at or above 95 percentile for the same age adolescent of same age and sex. And severe obesity, when BMI is more than 99 percentile, that is defined as the severe obesity. So why they become obese? Nowadays, because of improving socioeconomic status, there is a now no food deficiency. So all as they mature, so adolescent, as they mature, they spend less time with the family, more time with peer, and there is a strong peer effect. So jo hamare friends khate wo hum khayenge, aur wo friends kya khate to zyadatar fast food hi khate hain, aur it contains lot of sugar, salt and maida, flour. So all this is a then eating away from home and during is increased during adolescent period. They prefer more unhealthy food, and fast food accounts for 33% of food eaten by the adolescent. Like from the their total caloric requirement, 33% is eaten in form of fast food. The occurrence of meal skipping is increased, and breakfast is the most commonly skipped meals. And in survey, it was found that adolescent who consume breakfast daily was significantly, their weight was lower versus those who only sometimes or never consume breakfast. So breakfast consumption was associated with greater physical activity versus those who never consume breakfast. So anytime any adolescent comes in contact with us, we should advise them to never skip breakfast. Other problems of obesity is the development of hypertension, blood pressure, heart, coronary artery disease, and malignancies. So what are the consequences of childhood and adolescent obesity? Nowadays, it is proved that metabolic syndrome, root of metabolic syndrome is started in childhood or the adolescent phase. And this lead to hypertension, diabetes, coronary artery disease, joint problems. In girl, PCOS is a most common cause of menstrual irregularities. even apart from these all physical problems, they have mental and psychosocial problems also. They have very low self-esteem. They may become a victim of bullying by their peers. So all this lead to psychosocial problem also. So what we can do to prevent obesity in adolescent? Diet management is the first and foremost things to be advised. We should advise them that they should eat all three meals, breakfast, lunch and dinner. Never skip breakfast first thing. Drink lot of water and nutritive value of the food. We should explain them. Then we should insist them for regular physical activity of moderate to high intensity for 60 minutes at least 5 days in a week. And other most important thing is lifestyle and behavior modification. Nowadays, all adolescents are very much active on the social media and they use electronic gadgets for longer period of time. So reduce screen time, regular sleep hygiene is the most important. Lack of sleep and irregular sleep pattern is also one of the cause of obesity, development of the obesity. Second, this is a very stressful phase. Like I said, that they are appearing for their board exams and all career selection. So how to manage stress, we have to explain them. And behavioral therapy also useful in prevention of the obesity. Another problem, in adolescent phase, many mental health related problem also emerge. Anorexia nervosa is also one of the mental health related eating disorder problem. So it is more common in 15 to 19 year old and more common in girls. What are the characteristics of this eating disorder, anorexia nervosa? So body weight is less than 85% of expected weight for age and height, but they have intense fear of becoming fat. Even though they are underweight, there is amenorrhea. There is a disturbed body image. They have body image issues. Anorexia is also commonly associated with other mental health disorders like depression, anxiety, suicidal ideation, and obsessive compulsive disorder. There is a profound weight loss because they don't eat at all. So profound weight loss may result in hypothermia, hypotension, dependable edema, bradycardia, hypokalemia, metabolic alkalosis, all metabolic derangement. And mortality is also very high and mostly it is attributed to cachexia and suicide. Another eating disorder is bulimia. It is also more common in girls, but it is between 10 to 19, the most common in 10 to 19 year of age. And this is characterized by the recurrent episode of binge eating. They go on eating something and as thodi thodi der pe kuch na kuch khate rehte hain. And later on, it is followed by inappropriate compensatory behavior to prevent weight gain, such as they self-induced vomiting or misuse of laxative. They may use diuretics or they do fasting or they do excessive exercise. And fasting and excessive exercise both at least twice a week for 3 months. Then we can define them as they are suffering from bulimia. And they have, here also, they have some mental illness, comorbid mental illness like depression or psychosis. Management of eating disorder are psychotherapy. They need cognitive behavior therapy individually also, and they need family therapy also. Nutritional rehabilitation is most important part of their treatment. And in severe cases, they require indoor hospitalization. And in severe cases, they may require nasogastric or parenteral nutrition. And medical pharmacological treatment also required, that is in form of antidepressant and antipsychotic. Mostly these two diseases are always treated in collaboration with psychiatric friend. Only pediatrician cannot treat them because mostly they are associated with other mental health disorders. Another very important problem with adolescent is a substance disorder. It is a medico-socio-economic disease, and 70% of adult who has started using, they have confronted that key, we have started use of substance in their adolescent phase. So why it happened? Because it is the age of experimentation. They like to take risk-taking behavior also. Here the brain is under construction. So what happened? Any substance used by adolescent, it act as a neurotoxins, and it immediately hijack the reward system of brain, and it permanently damage hippocampus and prefrontal cortex. Some part of hippocampus and prefrontal complex is permanently damaged. So later on, they also have a problem of memory loss and all problem, and they become victim of substance use. Most commonly, the reason why they start, mostly they start under the peer pressure or out of curiosity. And some may use it as a stress reliever, easy availability. When anyone in the family, if they are having substance use disorder, like if parents is having alcohol or tobacco or smoking habit, then there are more chance that their children may become the victim of substance use disorder. In India, alcohol, tobacco, cannabis, and opium are the most prevalent substance use abuse in Indian adolescent. And these addicts are more prone to accident, injuries, violence, trading, sex for drugs, HIV infection, and other sexually transmitted disease. So all adolescent should be screened for drug use at every healthcare visit. Loving and caring, there are risk factor and protective factor. What are the protective factors? Are so loving and caring family atmosphere and parents and family atmosphere. High adolescent with high self esteem and very good coping skill. Adolescent with positive attitude, and adolescent who have a very positive peer relationship, they are protected by this substance use disorder. Those children who become a victim of child sexual abuse or child physically abuse, or if they are neglected there by parents, poverty, mental health disorder like ADHD and depression, academic, children who have academic problems, or those who cannot adjust in the school, they all are having high risk for developing substance abuse. And most importantly, peer who are having substance use or drug abuse, their friends are more likely to become substance use. So this is very important algorithm. Any adolescent come to our office, we have to ask just one question. In the past year, how many times you have used tobacco, alcohol, or marijuana? This is called screening, brief intervention, and referral to treatment. From this one question, we can decide if there is any substance use is there or not, and how severe it is. So if we find that he or she is not using any drugs or any addictive substance, then it is no use. They come under category of no substance use disorder, and we have to appreciate the adolescent and giving them positive reinforcement. And every 3 monthly or 6 monthly, we should call them in the follow-up. If it is once or twice, then it is once and twice in last 1 year. Then we have to ask them which prescription drugs they are using. And we have to give them brief advice. We should give them knowledge regarding the ill effect of all substance use. And we have to encourage them and motivate them not to use substance. And again, they can be treated at home only. There is no need to reference to hospital. Those who use it monthly or weekly, they comes under mild to moderate or severe. And here, motivational intervention is required. They need cognitive behavior therapy and their health problems, other health problems should be assessed. And if it is severe, then they should be referred to psychiatrists also or other colleague whosoever required. Other mental health problems are depression and suicide, anxiety and panic disorder, schizophrenia, adjustment disorder, delinquent behavior, poor body image, and low self-esteem. Otherwise, as such, it is says that adolescents are in very good health. They are rarely perceived to be ill, while in fact, they have significant morbidity and mortality related to mental health problem. And most of this mental health problem is neglected by doctors also, because it is most of the mental health illnesses cannot be recognized during routine healthcare visit. So India is a depression. India consistently documents the highest suicide rate in the world, and majority of completed suicide had been seen within the adolescent age group. Adolescents are at higher risk of committing suicide because of their cognitive immaturity and increased impulsivity. Prevalence of depression among Indian adolescents was 13.3% using PHQ-9 screening. And depression is the top cause of illness and disability among adolescents, and suicide is the this is for world. In India, suicide is the first cause of death among the adolescent. So what are the symptoms of adolescent depression? Persistent sadness and irritability, significant loss of interest in the activity which they like most. There is a psychomotor agitation and retardation, fatigue. There is a change in appetite and weight, feeling of worthlessness, impairment in relationship with friends and family, scholastic backwardness, sleep disturbance, and suicide ideation and suicide. So statistics says completed suicides are higher in boys and attempted suicides are higher in girls. So what is the management? Psychotherapy. Here also cognitive behavior therapy, interpersonal and family therapy is required. Pharmacotherapy in form of selective reuptake inhibitor therapy and mood stabilizer are required. And most importantly, building life skill in children and adolescents and providing them with the psychosocial support in school and other community setting is most important thing. How we can prevent suicide? Then life skill education, building teen resilience is most important thing. Stress management, we should teach them how to manage stress. Healthy media usage is most important, and community awareness program for youth to prevent suicide is very much important. Another is a sexual health related problem. In that, first we'll see problem related to menstruation and menstrual hygiene, dysmenorrhea, premenstrual syndrome, irregular menstrual cycle, oligomenorrhea, and menorrhagia are the most common menstruation related problem. Commonest is the dysmenorrhea. 67.2% girls are reported that they are having symptoms of dysmenorrhea, and 61.13% girls reported premenstrual syndrome. Dysmenorrhea is defined as a crampy lower abdominal pain related to menstrual flow, often accompanied by other biological symptoms, including sweating, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. And this is the most common reason of absenteeism from the school. It disturbs the girl's daily routine. So she may need prolonged bed rest, miss social activity and commitment. There is a disturbed sleep and decreased appetite also. Premenstrual syndrome is a recurring cyclic disorder in the luteal phase of menstrual cycle. It involving behavioral, psychological and physical change, and this usually disappears within 2 days of blood flow. This characterized by the cluster of symptoms like weight gain, abdominal bloating, breast enlargement and pain, irritability, anxiety, inability to concentrate, and depression. Management of premenstrual syndrome is the reassurance, low salt and high protein diet, and regular exercise. Another very common problem, as we have seen, that more than 54% girls are married before 18 years of age. So they early pregnancy and childbirth is a major health problem in the adolescent phase. If these complications linked to pregnancy in children are the second cause of death from 15 to 19 years old girl globally. Every year, sub 3 million girls aged 15 to 19 years undergo unsafe abortion. Babies born to adolescent mother substantially higher risk of dying than those born to women aged 20 to 24 years. And unmarried adolescents are likely to go for unsafe method of abortions, which increase the risk of complications like septicemia and also death. Adolescent pregnancy are also at increased risk of preeclampsia, preterm labor, prolonged and obstructed labor, postpartum hemorrhage, and such pregnancies are 2 to 4 times likely to die during childbirth as compared to adults. Many girls who become pregnant have to drop out of school. And newborn to adolescent mother are also more likely to have low birth weight, and with the risk of all long-term consequences. How we can prevent? So increase the age of marriage. It is now even government is thinking the age of marriage of girl to raise to 21 years in India also. Creating understanding and support to reduce pregnancy before the age of 20 years. We should promote the use of contraception by adolescent at risk of unintended pregnancy. Reducing coarse sex among adolescent. Reducing unsafe abortion among adolescent. And increase use of skilled antenatal, childbirth, and postnatal care adolescent. Another sexual reproductive health problem in adolescent is HIV and other sexually transmitted disease. As we have seen that more than 50% of all HIV positive new infections are in the age group of 10 to 25 years. As such, child marriage is very common in India, but those adolescents who are not married, in that also earlier sexual activity is very common. There is some biological factors which lead to more HIV infection in adolescent girl, like immature and incompletely estrogenized mucosa, vaginal mucosa. Other psychosocial factor like lack of preparedness or lack of familiarity with barrier contraceptive method This all makes an adolescent susceptible to this infection. Vaginal discharge is common in adolescent girl and may signify physiological leukorrhea of puberty or endogenous or sexually transmitted infection. And adolescent girl, if they have also any sexually transmitted disease, there are high chance of pelvic inflammatory disease, and this will lead to spectrum of inflammatory disorder in female genital tract. It can present with abdominal pain and vaginal discharge to more severe condition. Related to HIV, more than 2 million adolescents are living with HIV. And all HIV death decrease in last 8 years, but adolescent related HIV death are rising. And young people need to know how to protect themselves. And this includes being able to obtain condom and prevent sexual transmission of the virus and using clean needle and syringe, those who use injectable drugs. And better access to HIV testing and counseling is also the most important part. As adolescents are passing through psychosocial changes, violence and injury is also very common among adolescents. Physical and sexual violence are common in India. 20 to 30% of young females suffering from domestic violence and 5.9% young female reported sexual violence according to National Family Health Survey 3. Motor vehicle and industrial accidents are more common in boys, whereas burns are more common in girls. Whenever any patient with injury comes to you, adolescent patient comes to you, we should remember this FIST mnemonic, that is F-I-S-T-S. F is for fighting. How many fights were you in last year? What was the last? Injuries. Have you ever been injured? Have you ever injured someone else? Sex. Has your partner hit you? Have you hit your partner? Have you ever forced to have sex? T is for threats. Has someone with a weapon threatened you? What happened? Anything changed to make you feel safer? And S is for self-defense. What do you do if someone tries to pick a fight? Have you ever carried a weapon in self-defense? This is cyberbullying, youth gang, and teen dating violence are the other three different types of violence which adolescent may. So what are the treatment? The adolescent which shows persistent, violent and aggressive behavior, they require proper treatment. Here also cognitive behavior therapy involving individual and family, and specific family intervention, that is parent management training and multi-system training is also required. In severe cases, pharmacotherapy also required. And most importantly, treatment of existing comorbidic condition like attention deficit hyperactive disorder, depression, substance abuse is also required to reduce aggressive behavior of the teen. So all these problems, what is the role of pediatrician? Pediatrician can be a bridge between parents and adolescent, and he is the right person to make the parents aware that child is growing and changing now. Pediatrician can be the advocate of adolescent as they have rapport with both the important parties, the parents as well as the adolescent. And it is a unique opportunity for the pediatrician. Pediatrician and other primary healthcare providers are an important source of healthcare information for adolescent and young adults and play a significant role in addressing their reproductive and sexual healthcare need. And pediatrician has a chance to build a safe, happy, healthy, and productive nation in the future. So all these comprehensive adolescent health care we can provide to adolescent. And mostly now we have to adopt the adolescent friendly clinics, and it is a need of hour. And all the adolescents should be screened on regular basis. So, what are the services provided by adolescent friendly health service? They should provide management of sexual violence, forensic examination and collection of blood and other body fluid samples. They should provide care for injuries, prophylaxis against pregnancy, against sexually transmitted disease and HIV, adolescent vaccination, and psychological support to adolescent. This is in brief regarding adolescent health problem. Each and every topic can be having a discussion of 1 to 2 hours in depth. But here I have just tried to show you the what are the adolescent health related problem. Dermatological and sports injury I have not included in detail, because these are the problems. This will directly and indirectly affect the adolescent health in present also and in future also. So thank you for patience hearing. If you have any questions, you can ask me.
Okay.
Deepa, a very big topic and you covered very well.
Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry.